Morning. So this is Sundeep, and we'll be looking at transtats now to track translation string change. So basically, we'll be covering the tracking translation string change part today, and we'll look at jobs, how to run jobs in transtats, and how they contribute to different levels of processes in L10N and IT10N stuffs. So let's get started. So these are the topics we are looking at. First is why transtats, the challenges it face and challenges it tries to solve. Second is what are the touch points through which users can get some interest using this, and how to use jobs to actually track something and actually create diff, to use it at server and how to use it by client. And what is next coming in transtats at the level of developments and integrations to different systems, and how we can actually get involved at two levels, maybe to just try and test and maybe to start contributing into the project. So first is why transtats? What is the need of transtats and why it is required? In L10N process, in localization process as a whole, in the life cycle, there are some challenges which we are facing, and these challenges are, first is how to track strings of packages have been duly pushed and pulled from respective translation platform. Second is latest strings are being packaged and built in Koji. So these are the two major bottlenecks where how actually we can track this so that packages could be in sync. So transtats actually try solving this by comparing translation statistics derived from different places. The places are upstream repository, translation platform, and build system. Second challenge is what is the volume of translation required for next Fedora release. This is actually required by L10N team at very early stage to have an estimate what would be the volume and in which languages. So answer to this is transtats release summary can tell us volume of translation required per languages. The third point is, can we fix major translation bugs reported after translation deadline and before final phrase? This is related to QE point of view, and answer to this is YML based jobs can pass packaged SRPM to check criticality of translation bugs. Actually, everything will be very clear in the demo. So I'm just explaining the answers to what are the challenges are and how we are getting these answers in transtats. The fourth is, which set of languages need attention? And the fifth is there any way to automate few steps? So answer to this is, in transtats, we have the system whereby we can find the packages which are out of sync, which has differences from translation platform versus what is being built into build system. And then yes, we can actually have some automation by adding few tasks in YML based jobs, and those automation can be achieved. So these are the challenges, and these are the respective answers to these challenges. Now we'll see how we can actually get to these answers. What are the touch points in transtat? So left hand side we have the, actually this is the release milestones. For translations point of view, there are two major milestones. The first is software string freeze, and second is translation deadline. So software string freeze is the point where the developer has to stop doing all the changes in string, and then translator has to start their translation work. And translation deadline is where translators are supposed to finish all the tasks, and then QE people has to test everything so that things could be packaged and well shipped. In transtats, we have some features like translation update volume and coverage, the packages which are out of sync. And two features are linked to out of sync packages. First is string change, and second is languages which need attention. So these are the features which are available in transtats and which can actually solve many of the challenges as we have discussed in previous slide. So now let's look at how to use jobs. In Transtats, why jobs? So jobs is really very flexible in the terms of creation. We can run them, we can save, we can schedule, and we can share. Schedule is in progress, it is not available yet, but others we can do. The predefined job types are like, there are two basic types. First is predefined jobs, second is YML based jobs. So in predefined, everything is defined, we can't change them. And they are basically to sync with different parts so that we can fetch out different data and store them in Transtats. In predefined jobs, we have sync build tags just to have all the build tags which are available in Koji to get into Transtats. Second is sync with translation platform to have all the information from translation platform regarding projects, their details, and high-level overview metadata. Third is sync with the release calendar. This is why this is important, because actually there are certain dates which keep slipping a week or so. So we should have all the latest milestones in Transtats. So this jobs handles that. Now next is YML based job. These are very interesting part in Transtats. These are YML based and we can actually go and define them. So the first is sync with upstream, that is Git repositories. Second is downstream, that is Koji build system. Third is string change. Fourth is verify translations. Verify translation is in progress. I mean development is in progress. It is not yet available. And the last one is inspect jobs. There is a page or there is a section whereby we can inspect all the jobs, how they are, like what has happened running them. So this is actually log view. So it has list and detailed view. So we are going to see each and everything in so much of detail now. Sync YML job template. So this is actually job templates. So here you can see that in sync, this is upstream sync job template, where what it does, it clones the Git repository, filter all PO files, and calculate statistics on the basis of those PO files. This is sync downstream job template, where it takes the build system. It supports two build systems. First is Koji and second is Brew. And it takes package name, build tag we are running this job for. What it will do, it will get the latest build info, download SRPM, unpack that SRPM, load a spec file, and then unpack tarball, and apply patch which are available in spec file, then filter PO files and calculate statistics. So the beauty of this is we can actually go and remove this step, or we can add an additional step. So this is a lot more flexible. Now let's move to another templates. These are actually templates to track a string change. So this is the first template. Like for a string change, it requires two things. First is package name, second is release slug. Why release slug is required? Because suppose you are tracking for Fedora 29, so we are actually keeping branch mapping for each and every package. I'll explain what is the branch mapping. And through branch mapping, we are getting to the point, like suppose it is for Fedora 29. So through branch mapping, we are calculating like which is the project version of translation platform for the package where translations for Fedora 29 are kept or are being done. So that calculation we are, that mapping we are getting from release slug. Now for task thing, we are cloning Git repository and branches master. It is well configurable. Like it supports Git repository. As of now, SVN and other things are not yet supported, but you can mention branch here. Currently it is master, you can mention whatever you want. And then it, then actually after cloning, it will generate the pod file from the source itself. Now why domain is required? This is the command you have to give to generate that particular pod file. So by default it will show Intel tool command, which is being used by almost every GNOME packages, and few of the packages are slowly moving into getText based system where this command will not work, like Anaconda. So for those systems I'll show like which command will work. And this is the command. Here we have to give the command to generate pod file. And domain is required because some of the packages do not have the same name for their pod file. So we actually need to give domain so that it can generate pod file of that particular domain. And to download pod file from translation platform of the same release we are running this job for, and then it will calculate the differences between pod file which are at translation platform and pod file we are generating from source repository. So if we create diff from these two, we'll be getting what are the strings which has been changed. Now this is like upstream, like Git repository versus translation platform, and this is like translation platform versus what is being built picture. So this is under development, but the steps are written here. So the first step is download and unpack latest SRPM from build system. Create fresh translation template like pod file from the source tarball. So we'll be repeating this step here itself. Then pull translation from translation platform. This is very tricky because we have to pull each and every translation for all the locales from translation platform. Then we are actually merging those translations to newly created pod file which is in set 1, and then we are applying patch and filtering PO files. So we are actually having two sets. First is set 1 which we have generated right now, and second is the set which we have found in the SRPM. So if we create diff between these two, then we'll find diff for each locale and what has been packaged versus what is being translated. So this will solve most of the problems we are facing in localization cycle. And if we see the results of these two, then actually we can answer many of the questions like what was breaking and what was not in sync. So now let's see them in action. So this is an important slide, like if we find some differences. So this is like string changes detected, and if it is after string freeze date, then it should be a breakage. So we should send a warning to maintainer. And if it is after translation deadline, so it could be an error, so we should alert a quality engineer that it is an error. So actually once it is integrated to different systems, we can actually redirect those messages to Bugzilla, and then we can handle several errors as well. And there are just four steps at server through which we can run these jobs. The first step is we have to pick the template. The second is we have to define task in the terms of YML file. Then we have to set values. In YML file we have some variables like package name, release slug and those all things. So we have to set those values and then we can trigger the job. So now it's time for demo. So I have recorded everything and I'll be keep explaining. So this is the landing page of Transtats in which we have just 5 packages where these are the messages and what has been translated, not translated. The packages, in packages section we can see each and every package in so much of detail. So we have selected one package, the first one, that is Ebert, I think. So this is the page for Ebert, and this is coming from upstream, and the one having yellow background is coming from downstream. Now see in Anaconda everything is coming from translation platform because their background color is just normal. So these are the statistics which we are getting from translation platform. This is the branch mapping I was talking about for Anaconda. Now since we don't have statistics from downstream, we are going and selecting the downstream package job, and this is the YML file for downstream sync. Now we are going to run this job. So it will do everything which has been written in YML file. First it will go and see which is the latest build which has been into Koji, and then fetches out those details, download the SRPM file from the Koji build system. unpack that SRPM, load spec file, and this is actually loading spec file into a Python object, so it is very flexible. Now it is unpacking tarball and then applying patch, no patches has been found, filtered all the PO files, and then at last it will calculate statistics. Why it is flexible? Because it is loading each and every PO file in Python object. So if we are getting some error, like syntax error or something in PO file, so here itself it will show like we have found one error or whatsoever. So it is very important and it is very interesting tool to inspect into SRPM. So this is how we are getting translation statistics of Anaconda at the build system packaged level. So now let's move back to Anaconda detail page. Yeah, this is the job success URL. Here you have the YML file which has been run, and this is the log of output of each and every step what has been performed at the server level. And the good point is we can actually share this URL. So this is what I was talking about. You can just copy that URL and share across so that everybody can know that what is the current statistics of Anaconda package at branch map at build level. Now let's move back to Anaconda. Here we are having statistics of Anaconda from Koji build system for Fedora 29, and now generate statistics diff. Once we are generating, it will show that these languages are not complete at Koji level. So these languages need attention for Anaconda package for Fedora 29. Now let's move to GNOME initial setup. In initial setup, everything has been synced. We have statistics from Koji build system. We have statistics from translation platform. So we can directly go and generate diff. So once we generate diff, it is in red color, that is Chinese traditional, and it is showing 1%. That means there are some strings translated at translation platform, but they are not being pulled and packaged. So that is why that is red and it is showing some differences. So this is for GNOME shell. And for GNOME shell, we just have Japanese. That is not complete at Koji. So let's move to Python May. For Python May, statistics has been generated and no languages found as need attention, so it is well and good for Python May for Fedora 29 as of now. Let's move to settings part, like how Transtats is keeping things in his database. So this is all languages. These are the translation platforms currently Transtats has. In products we have Fedora, Koji, and this is the release schedule of Fedora 29. So actually we can keep multiple products, like we can keep RHEL and Fedora at the same time. This is the packages and their list. Let's go and add one package, password D. So for adding a package, we need upstream URL. Copy upstream URL, that is pagure. And we need to give the name password D. Password D, the name has to be matched with whatsoever we have package name at translation platform. So validation is being done over there. And we select as Fedora, then add package. So now package D is being tracked for every release beneath of Fedora. So now you can see that everything is empty here. Like it is newly added package, so we don't have any statistics from any of the sources. Go and sync with translation platform. It will sync with Fedora Zenata currently. Transtat supports two translation platform, Damdlize and Zenata. So now it is fetching all the statistics available from Zenata, and here are the statistics. We have two project version, master and password. Now it's go and sync with upstream repository. So what it will actually do, it will go and clone the Git repository. It will filter PO files and calculate statistics. So it is cloning pagure repo, and this is the statistics we are getting from the repository, and this is the job success URL. once we land to pass the details page, we can see that we have statistics from upstream. And this is the branch mapping. Go and sync with downstream as well. So we have statistics from translation platform upstream, and we are getting statistics from build system. So mostly for Koji build system, we don't have any patches. For Brew build system, we do have, various patches which has to be applied. This is job success URL for password D, downstream sync. Now let's get back and calculate differences for password D. So this is all red, because for password D things has been translated at Zenata, but they have not been pulled and packaged. So we are getting differences here. So this solves some of our problem, like for package maintainer level or something. Once we refresh this, we can have statistics like how much of packages need attention. That is 4 currently for this instance. Once we land to Fedora 29 translation statistics, we can see the password D has been added and different statistics has been refreshed as well. So this is update volume thing, like what volume has been updated and in which languages we need most attention in the terms of translation. Once we refresh this, we can have statistics for each and every language, what is the number of untranslated messages. This is a shortcut to land to details page of each and every language for translation part. So these are the predefined jobs I was talking about. These are 3 in number: build tags, translation platform, and release schedule. And this is YML based job. It has 3 templates as of now. There are 4 steps: pick template, define task, set values, and trigger job. And let's see how things are being stored. So this is the YML for upstream sync, as we have done for so many packages. This is the YML for build system. And this is the YML for track string change. Now we will be running a couple of string change job to see actually how it works. These are inspect logs. This is the list view of logs, and this is for sync downstream and password D, what we have ran just now. These are the job IDs here. And this is the type, this is the remarks. In remarks, mostly we'll be having package name. And this is here, this is success or failed, whatsoever. The time taken, and this is the job details page URL. So hereby you can land to job details page. It has most of the details, like the time, the output, the input, YML, and everything. Yeah, here I was talking about, this is the command for Anaconda. So it is different from Intel tool. So this command is required for Anaconda pod file, and this is the steps which occurred when we fired that command to generate pod. 0 message default has been found for Anaconda, and in full diff you can actually see the entire line to line diff of Anaconda pod file, from the source to what has been created just now to what we have found at translation platform. So this is what I was talking about. As the message ID difference is 0, so we are safe at Anaconda. Now let's run it for some other package. So we are keeping the command as Intel tool itself, and we are just looking into ABERT. So we are just going and see like if do we have any branch for Fedora 29. As of now, we don't have any branch for Fedora 29 in ABERT. So we are just going ahead with master branch itself. And so here branch is master, recursive is true, and command would be Intel tool. Now let's select package ABERT and then release slug, that is Fedora 29, and run this job. So first it will clone the repository, entire repository, and then it will go and generate pod file. So pod file has been generated, and then we can see the differences which we are getting. So these are the differences which we are getting in ABERT. So for current master branch, if we'll consider it with Fedora Zenata ABERT, there are 14 messages which differ. So we have either 14 new messages, or we have some new messages and some has been updated. So we can have answer to them as well. So these are the output. These are the 14 messages which has been differ with their line numbers, like at which line they are differing. And once we click full diff, we'll be having line by line diff of pod file. On line number 176, we are having this line added. I mean, we are having this difference found. So now let's go and see. So here in full diff, you can see that this has been added to the pod file. And this is how we can actually go and see like which string has been added here, or which string has been updated and where. Now let's go ahead and run one more job with different command. So now we'll be looking at Python May. In Python May, in PO, we don't have any PO. We have one pod file. So, and we don't have podfile.in. So Intel tool update will not work here. We need to figure out like which command we have to give there to make it work. So it is make pod file simply for Python May. So it is just make pod file, and here we are keeping branch as master. The interesting part is we are adding one thing like overwrite as true, because we have pod file in repository and we don't want to use that pod file. We want to generate our own. So for that you have to add overwrite true. And once it's get added for Python May and release Fedora 29, run the job. So what it will do, it will clone the repository and it will delete that pod file, and then it will create the new pod file and then go and see the differences. So here we are safe because there is no new messages found for Python May. So job success URL is this, and you can see here that no messages differ. So this is actually message ID diff, and full diff is line by line diff. So everything is here on this page. And this is the URL which you can copy and share basically. In archive, I don't think, yeah, we don't have anything, because once we have more than 15 or 20 jobs run, then it comes to archive. And this is how it is being navigated. Like from list view, you can go and go to details page. We have a quick start page where you can go and read like how to get started with Transtats. Some of the FAQs are here itself, which will answer to most of the questions, most of the common questions basically. So this was the demo. Next is Transtat CLI. So what I was explaining in the server, Parag is going to explain everything with CLI as well. So over to Parag.
So I'm going to talk about the Transtat CLI. So basically why Transtat CLI is needed, because it is needed by the developers if they want to quickly track their translation status, or even by the translators if they want to know what is the current status of their package to which they want to contribute their translations. So yeah. It looks better now. Okay. So basically, in Transtat CLI, there are 5 commands have been developed. The first command that have been developed is the ping server to test whether the Transtat server is alive or not. Okay. This is the ping server. So basically, Transtats is using a REST API. So this Transtat CLI is just using this REST APIs. So this is the GET kind of API, the ping. It's a simple command. Second Transtat CLI thing is nothing but getting a package status. So package status is nothing but returning the translation stats of a package for enabled languages. I will show you the demo as well. So just let's go through these commands and their descriptions. So the package is one of the command for Transtat CLI. Third one is a graph rule coverage. So you can create your own rule and you can get the stats from for that package. So we have developed this command called as coverage. So it returns the translation coverage according to the graph rule. So you can create your own custom graph rule there. It's also a GET kind of command. Then the fourth one is a release status. It returns the translation stats of a package which are being tracked for a given release. So suppose you now want to track suppose for any branch, so release branch. So let's say the current release branch is Fedora 29. So you can use this release command. The recent one that we have developed in the current Transtat CLI release is a job command, and this was one of the biggest command that has been developed into the Transtat CLI. So job details, so we have 2 sub commands that have been added here, job run and job log. So with the job run, you can run the jobs of 3 different types. That is nothing but a sync upstream job type, sync downstream job type, and string change job type. And when you run this through Transtat CLI, you will get a URL, and in order to view the log from that URL, you need to use another subcommand, that is Transtat's job log, and you need to give the log ID that is written from the run command. So like the example has been added, it's this big job ID has been generated for the each job that you are going to submit, and you can just substitute that job ID in that instead of that job ID field, and you will get the log. So so these are the commands that have been developed into the Transtats CLI. Yeah, so like I said before, Transtats CLI is written in Python. It uses REST API and the code is hosted on the GitHub. So we have a Transtats organization on GitHub where you can find the code for the Transtats server as well as this Transtats CLI. This also provides output in JSON format as well as a normal format. So basically the output that is coming from the Transtats server is in a JSON format, but in order to make sure that the end user will read it properly, we have made a default output format as a normal text format. But to all these command we have added a --json JSON option. So if you add a --json JSON option, output in JSON format only. So there are two types of output format available through Transtats CLI. And yeah, in summary, coverage, job, package, release and version are the five commands that are available. So I can show you. We do have a man page in the Transtats CLI package. Transtats CLI package is available in Fedora as well as for EPL 7 as well. And this is the man page. So the same information is available here, like commands, coverage, package, version, release, job. And we do have examples also for end users, how to run it. So suppose Transtats release you want for Fedora 27, then if you want in detail you can use a detail option, version. Okay, I think we better so just if you want to test what version Transtats is currently using, so you can just use a command Transtat version, so it will just return a client version. But if you want to know what Transtats server version is, then you can just add a --- server option and you will get to know. So currently Transtats client is at 0.20 version and Transtats server at 0.16-RC2 version. So this is one of the big output commands. So if you want to know about the status for the any package, say Anaconda, so I mean, I have already run this command here. Oh, it's already returned the output. So see, so for every branch that is available, like rel 7 is there, rel 6 is there. So it will give you the output in this format, like for African language, say the completion status is 1.09% only. For Albanian, it's 79.92. So it's a bit easy, but it's yes, I can understand it's lengthy. So we are just adding a sub options for easy to get the information in the output. Like if there are, you can see if there are 5 or 6 branches, it will give you the all the output along with all the enabled languages for that package. So the package command can be used to get the status for all the available branches for all the available languages. So I think I will cover this because this is very important thing, Transtats job. So Transtats job, so how to run this command. So Transtats job run, and then which kind of a job type you want to choose. Say suppose string change, you want to test whether there has been any stream change happen for the gnome shell package, and then that too into the Fedora 29 branch stream. Then this is the command. So once I run this command, I got a job log, and in order to see the log, yep, so this is the command, transtat job log job id. So it will just return in a normal text format, like what is the job id, what was the job type for this job, what is the start time, end time, and the YAML template that just this previously we have seen different YAML templates that one can use to submit the job. So it also returns what YAML text has been used for this job. So this is that. So it just clone and generate a pod file, and it used this command, downloaded the pod file. So yeah, so this is how we're just trying to make it as pretty as possible, so that the end user, like developer and translator, can understand or can pass it at the CLI level only, instead of going to the web and look into the log files. Yeah, I mean server just returns it. Server generates some job ID once you submit a job. And as I'm using a REST API, I'm just getting that thing. So like I explain you, let's see how much time it gets. So JSON outputs are also available, or maybe I can show you this quick. If you want output in JSON format, you can get it. It takes some time. Haha, something gone wrong. See, here we got the output in JSON format. It's success, job created and log, and we got it. Job URL, job ID. So yeah, I mean, this is the way. I mean, you can use the Transtats CLI, and it will be easy for developers and translators to quickly interact with the Transtats server and to get the status. Yes, we have a release command. Fedora 29, and yeah, let's see. I mean, it's gonna take some time. Haha, it broke. So so this is the way release and release slug, and then we have added a local sub option to get only local information, particular local information. Sorry?
I was not thinking of a third package.
Do you want to address?
Sure. So actually, when we'll go to server, then we can actually see that can you navigate to server? I mean, maybe transtats.xyz. So click on dashboard, basically. Right. So here we have Fedora 28 and 29 statistics. Just scroll down, yeah, and scroll this bar. So here we have all the languages which have some untranslated messages. And once we click on any of the languages, here we can see that what are the packages, what is the total translated package, messages, and what are not. So this is the navigation for entire release to languages to messages kind of thing. And click on dashboard once. So basically we have two tabs. First is releases and second is packages. So if you want to get into packages navigation, just select second tab. And then you can select any of the packages, and then you can see all the packages stuffs. So basically it is categorized with release and packages, and similarly we have two commands, release and packages at CLI also. So hence categorization is being done. So should we move further in the present? Thank you, Parag, for covering CLI part. Now what's next? So the next in development plans are this. First and most priority thing is to deploy Transtats in Fedora infrastructure. Second is to have some more templates in YAML-based jobs like verify trans, which is still in progress. Third is better UI to eliminate navigation confusions. And for this, we are developing new dashboard. Fourth is Transtats job scheduling feature. To avoid all manual go and run jobs thing. Fifth is notification about string change, breakage, and translation deadlines to their counterparts, and better user guide. We have very short demo for, screen recording for new dashboard as well. So this is how new dashboard will look like. This is created using Patternfly, and here we have all the navigations like dashboard, packages, jobs, languages, platform, and custom graphs. So by default we'll land at release page, and here the stuffs are similar to what we have currently. So we have planned the migration from old to new dashboard somewhere around in September, and this is everything which you are having currently in the old UI. This is locale to details page navigation. And these are just the tooltips for different fields. This is release schedule page where you can see the release schedule of Fedora. Which are very much linked to translations. This is summary page of packages, and this is the list view of all the packages. Once you'll select any of the packages, you will land to their details page. Like we are going to Ebert's detail page, and this is the details page for Ebert. The internal look like is very much similar to what we have currently, but the outer and outer skin is being changed. So it will avoid all the navigation confusions, and it will give us opportunity to actually go and include all the things which is actually required at UI level. So this is languages page. where we can actually filter everything using shortcuts and see the language list. Similarly for platform, so these are the platforms which actually we can support any number of engine. Like if we have four instances of Zenata, we can support all four. If we support Damdlize, and for the some parts we support Transifex as well. So there are several translation platforms which these are the custom graph rules on the basis of which coverage graphs are being generated. Like, and these are the filters which is being added. So in the coverage we can add different filters and filter those rules on the basis of that. And this is the coverage graph. So we are in the process to modify this graph to be more meaningful currently, which is probably not. Let's select one and then this is the about dialog of Transtats. So this has incorporated, and this is still into progress, I think. So let's move to the next slide, which is for integrations. So we have some planned integration for Transtats with Bodhi, so that we can have some automated test plugin. We should be updating us like if there is any string breakage or not, and if there is string breakage, then it should flag maintainer. Second is message queues like fed MSG. It is very important to have in sync with if we found any translation error in any of the packages, then we can respond to that error if we have an answer in Transtats. Third is chat process like IRC bot. This is interesting. Like in IRC bot, if we can link that to Transtats, then we can have some commands through which we can actually go and see what is happening behind the scenes and why things are breaking through IRC itself. In get involved, we can get involved with Transtats by first test and try deployments. So for deployments, you can just pull Docker image using this command, docker pull docker io transtats transtats, and run that image. So application will be available at port 8080, the server, with some of the sample data. And this is the steps for OpenShift deployment. You can go to github.com/transtats for all these things. And if you want to contribute, you can get the development environment in just four commands. It uses And these are the technical specs of the project. Project URL is transtats.org, docs is at docs.transtats, and source is at GitHub. So anytime if you would be interested in looking into it, you can go to these URLs and you can find details there. So if you like the idea, you can go and submit one feedback, feedback.transtats.xyz. Why I'm looking forward this, because I have some questions to have further development in Transtats, so that we can decide on priority, like which things we should do first. And we are available at Fedora Globalization and at Transtat channel in IRC Freenode. So now I'm open for questions if somebody wants to discuss. We can integrate it to the documentation, but we actually go like, what is the actual use case for that. For example, most probably you will be having some projects at Zenata where you are pushing all docs file to get them translated and pull them back. So we can add those repository into Transtats, and then we can have tracking there. So this is one use case. Are you talking about this use case, or do you have any other?
For example, in the other room, there is a talk about the new doc style and okay. New platform for that. And is it integrated with it?
Currently, it is not, but we are looking forward to it. thanks. Thank you so much. So, any other questions?
Like
So basically I would say this is ready. So you can have these things in Transtats as of now. So we can have translation update volume, and we can go and see for out of sync packages, string change languages which need attention and coverage. Yes, yes, at transtat.xyz it is available, and it is available for almost 90 packages and for 70 languages. I'm thankful to Rafael, he has submitted one bug for Portuguese, so I'll fix that, yeah. I'll fix that. I've seen that, and it needs some backend changes. So I keep and hold. I'll fix that. So most probably I'll do that today. Sure. See, for that actually you need to get into nitty-gritties, like which projects you are handling underneath of what. So suppose you have 10 projects, so you need to create 10 projects at Zanata where or whatsoever your translation platform is, and then you need to add those projects in Transtat so that tracking could be enabled for those packages. So whatsoever packages are being added to Transtats, they are being tracked. So actually we need to get into that. Like, do you have anything to add in your question? Like,
For example, yesterday today we talked about how to get a federated web link.
Okay. Basically for this system, on the basis of that, we don't have any plans as of now. We are just creating some instance for Fedora RHEL, and then we'll be looking forward for other platforms as well. Like if we are looking at a weblet, so first we need to enable all the weblet counterparts in Transtats as we have enabled it for Zanata. So if we have some APIs in weblet, we have to consume those APIs, and then we can add projects which are in weblet to Transtats. So this could be one use case, but it will require a small study before we go ahead, simply. So anyone has further questions, or we should break out for lunch? Okay, thank you. Thank you for joining.